Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. This is a pathology video on bone pathology. The topic is Salmonella and Tubercular Osteomyelitis. This is by Dr. CSBR Prasad, Professor of Pathology, Sri Devrajaras Medical College.
And one more important practical point is Salmonella osteomyelitis. So all Salmonella can induce inflammation in any varieties of sites of the body, but Salmonella osteomyelitis may be confined to a particular disease patients known as sickle cell anemia. They are more prone for this Salmonella osteomyelitis. So clinical features: acute osteomyelitis is a illness associated with fever, chills, malaise, and there may be leukocytosis and other evidences of acute inflammation like raised ESR and raised CRP, and the typical description of pain, that is throbbing pain over the affected area, is characteristic of acute osteomyelitis, where there will not be any X-ray findings, but still if you drill that area, your pus will jet out. So, diagnosis is characteristic radiographic findings if they are there, that is lytic focus and bone destruction surrounded by sclerosis. And tuberculosis osteomyelitis always is a secondary tuberculosis. They come through hematogenous spread, and young adults are affected. Spine and long bones are involved commonly in this process, and if the spine is involved, there may be a compression fracture of the vertebra, and it may be associated with the later development of the paraplegia if it is not tackled properly. So it is known as POTS disease. And vertebral body may be collapsed, or a disc involved. So the disc may be eroded by this inflammation, and the infection may spread from one vertebra to the other vertebra. So compression fractures, I told already. And sometimes peculiarly, these abscesses or this inflammation may track through the natural passages and present in a different fashion. Say for example, if the vertebral tuberculosis osteomyelitis is there, the pus or the inflammatory exudate will track down anteriorly through the psoas sheath and produce a swelling in the inguinal region, which may be mistaken for inguinal hernia. Okay. Or sometimes it may track in the back, in the lumbar region. It may produce a swelling in the lumbar region. Okay. And there may be sinus formation in these patients. So you can see the deformity of the spine due to the compression fracture that is occurring due to tuberculosis process. And this is diagrammatic representation of the vertebral tuberculosis tracking on either side of the psoas sheath, and producing, it may produce a swelling in the inguinal region. And sometimes this vertebral osteomyelitis can produce lumbar swellings, and this is very typical appearance. So this is the X-ray appearance of tuberculosis osteomyelitis. You see this, the periosteum is lifted and there is production of new bone. So this produces a triangular shadow, which is called as Cartman's triangle. So, Cartman's triangle classically described to be associated with one of the bone tumors known as osteosarcoma. But anything that lifts the periosteum and irritates the periosteum may be associated with the new bone formation and this Cartman's triangle production. So, it is not confined exclusively to osteosarcoma, and it may be seen in chronic variety of osteomyelitis too. Thank you.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe by clicking the button subscribe.